about what it is that changes the face, and I was just saying that it's amazing that you wake up and you look in the mirror, Richard, and you see changes. And the changes are just so apparent. You look at pictures of yourself 20 years ago, and you have this wonderful rounding to the face, not a fat face, but that volume. And then I looked into the mirror, and there was hollowing and gravity pulling down. Is what he likes to call a fluid facelift. And he's going to be hopefully using different injectables to fill in the cheeks and lift the face without surgery. I lead a busy lifestyle and I don't want the downtime. And I want to leave here with just a little bit more fullness, a little bit more oomph, and I'm looking forward to it. It's going to be apparent that the volume is back in my face. It's immediate. He's going to inject stiffer fillers, we like to call stiffer, or larger molecule fillers, and that creates a little bit more of a hold for the structure of the skin. Then he's going to do a little bit of finer fillers, and that creates a little bit of what we call the art. So to fill in individual little lines, he'll come back and he'll do Restylane or Juvederm, and he's amazing, it's incredible. It's like layering, and you create a little bit of support and then a little bit of a art to just smoothing and refining the surface. We like to use a cocktail of Restylane, Juvederm, Radius, our favorite fillers. The durations vary. We do some of the fillers to create buttressing or support. So kind of like a bridge, or someone recently said a great example, when you have carpeting, you want padding under the carpeting. And my skin kind of needs that padding under the carpeting. And I hope it lasts a long time, as carpeting typically does. I'll try not to wear it out too quick. But the fillers typically last about 6 months to a year. And if you do the appropriate amount, they could even last longer. I've had it before, and when I've had it, I'm so thrilled, because sometimes it's a year and a half, and I look in the mirror and yay, he's still holding. But typically, as I do all the time, talk with my mouth, so I know that's gonna probably need a little more touch-up. Around my eyes should last a lot longer. Dr. Edelweiss is going to probably inject around the cheeks, the temples, creating a lift, which women of 30, 40, 50 and beyond love, and we need that little tweak. And I don't want to leave off men either. Years of experience, years of experimenting, but all of this is FDA approved, and I think experience counts. There are very few who do the finesse that I think Dr. Edelglass does. I'm a little biased. I've seen his work, I've experienced it, but I think, as you said, experience does count. He knows all the fillers, he knows how to use them, he does the research on many of them, or lectures on behalf of these companies, and because of that, I think he knows where they are appropriate, how much is appropriate, and he knows also that indescribable finesse of where to place it. There's an art to it as well. And in the hollowing face of maybe 50-year-old plus, as I am, he knows exactly where a woman needs it.